On September 4, Hong Kong CEO Carrie Lam finally declared the withdrawal of controversial extradition bill.
Incidents over these past 2 months have shocked and saddened Hong Kong people. We are all very anxious about Hong Kong, our home. We all hope to find a way out of the current impasse and unsettling times. First, the government will formally withdraw the bill in order to fully allay public concerns. Our foremost priority now is to end violence, to safeguard the rule of law, and to restore order and safety in society. As such, the government has to strictly enforce the law against all violent and illegal acts.
Beijing's backdown is being seen as a conciliatory move to boost confidence in Hong Kong's economy amid a spiraling downturn in key sectors such as finance, tourism and retail since protests broke out over 85 days ago. Asia's financial hub took a massive beating because of violent clashes and protests for the past 13 weeks. Lam's announcement is likely to assuage angry Hong Kongers as normalcy promises to return in the former British colony. Let's unpack why Hong Kong was protesting against the draconian extradition bill. What is the extradition bill? Trouble started in February 2018 when a young unmarried couple from Hong Kong traveled to neighboring Taiwan. However, 9 days later, only the man returned. And after a month, he confessed to killing his partner. The guilty could get away scot-free in Hong Kong as the purported crime was committed in Taiwan. There is no extradition treaty between Hong Kong and Taiwan, which China does not consider as a sovereign republic. In 2019, Hong Kong proposed an extradition bill to transfer suspects for trial back on its soil. The proposal was met with angry and violent response from Hong Kongers. The islanders feared that the contention bill was a way to increase mainland China's influence on the special administration region. They feared that anyone who opposed Beijing's policies would be extradited to the mainland and made to stand on trial on trumped-up charges.
The people of Hong Kong want to protect our freedom of speech, our rule of law, our judicial system, and also our economic foundation, which is a welcome to international investor. If the international investor lose confidence in Hong Kong because of this evil bill, then the Hong Kong will economically would also be destroyed.
Hong Kong's unique political problem. Hong Kong is a special administrative region of the People's Republic of China under a unique one country, two system formula. Though Hong Kong is part of mainland China, it still enjoys some special democratic rights like freedom of speech and expression. But the privileges won't last for long. Hong Kong's special status expires in 2047 when it becomes a part of China. Why is the extradition bill suddenly in focus? Earlier, Hong Kong CEO Carrie Lam, seen as a Beijing stooge, has suspended the introduction of the extradition bill. Critics argued a complete withdrawal of the bill so that Lam couldn't push the Beijing's oblique agenda to rein in Hong Kong. The matter came to a head as Lam refused to give in to Hong Kongers' demand. Huge demonstrations crippled Hong Kong's economy for over 3 months. Hong Kong's date with protests. Hong Kong has been known to take on Beijing's hegemony since the United Kingdom transferred its former colony to China in 1997. In 2003, Hong Kongers successfully thwarted legislation that prohibited them from speaking out against China. In 2014, Hong Kongers protested against the mainland's influence over a democratically elected self-government. What will be the Hong Kongers' fate in 2047? The future may look bleak, but this is the moment to cherish their free will prevailing over Beijing's brute force.